Lord, give me strings.
Yeah, people are, I mean, people on the forums have said, suggested it. People have actually said that people, their friends have downloaded the game, set, realized how to go through a semi-lengthy tutorial and said, never mind, and uninstalled it just simply because they don't want to sit there through a fucking tutorial. And you know what? I mean, obviously we're not that, but yeah, I can see that.
Yeah, the single player, what the fuck? Wait, can you invite me now?
Oh yeah. Wait. You'd accept it?
Yes.
So pending. Oh,
I'm
fuck me.
in.
What happened?
I selected my pet first, then it let me go.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't
Now,
know. Have pets changed?
so they actually, since the patch we played in, we haven't played with this yet. Now, your pet no longer levels up with your account. You have your
That's right.
pet gives you straight up full benefits from the very beginning.
Oh, okay, cool.
It used to be like my pet would be max level. Ryan's, I think still wasn't max or was almost not
Pretty
long
close.
ago. And so he would have a pet. Yeah, his pet wasn't quite maxed out yet, so his was a slight disadvantage. But now all pets are equal if you whatever pet you choose.
Oh, damn, the fucking art on Lady Tenders is fucking amazing. Someone give me a boner.
Tinder, it will. So do you got now I have a question. Would
What?
you be more comfortable? I almost would even because I haven't played in a couple of weeks. Would you be more comfortable starting off with a bot match?
Yeah, probably.
I know because I mean, I don't do that long term, but I honestly, dude, I haven't since this game. I've been playing Diablo 3 since I stopped playing. I'm playing Diablo 3, which has a certain kind of move speed and feel to it. I've been playing Heroes of the Storm, which has a certain move and feel to it. And now today I'm playing Grim Dawn, which has a certain movement feel to it. So I kind of want to even do a bot game just to get reacclimated with exactly how the fuck to move and stuff. You know what I mean?
Yeah, Ryan, what do you think, bitch? Is that who you're playing?
Ryan's gonna play the brand new hero came out like a week ago. So we all have yeah. So let's we're doing a bot game.
I just drew
All right, hold
Zaku.
on.
Do what, Ryan?
Drew Zaku.
Oh, yeah, you did. And you're. Oh, I think I've seen. Oh, Malady?
That's my new love.
Yeah. Rule
Dude,
34 heard.
I went from hating her because I couldn't land her stun to understanding how to land it better to I don't play any other hero almost now, dude. I fucking love this bitch.
What's this shit plunder shit?
Oh, it's a new
Wait,
hero.
what? I'm fucking stupid as fuck.
There's two new pets.
Oh.
Dude, Ryan, I
Oh,
can get
I chose wrong pet.
What? Who'd you choose?
Oh no, I chose Mystic, I think.
Well, you can see on your character select screen.
I drew Zaku.
Okay.
Damn, dude, that's a really good drawing. Nice
Okay,
Easter
active
bunny.
ability, promote, pillage, and
Yeah,
resilience.
that's yeah, that is
I thought he had inspiration. It's a mana regen thing.
that's Mystic.
Fuck.
You don't have any
Buttons.
money either.
But it said the other ones were locked.
So maybe you pick
What?
your additional pet. Hold on. What screen are you on right now?
I'm on the pet screen.
Okay, click on play at the top.
Yeah.
Or click on play Strife. Are you on your character select screen?
Yeah.
Okay, you have Tinder pick, right?
Yeah.
And now you're on the main screen where it says pet. What does it say?
Parted.
John.
Oh. Hold up.
Respond so I can help.
No, I know I'm looking for it. Like, where'd my pet icon like show up? Jesus.
Okay, wait. On what screen? You have your hero picked, and right now there's a really bad art in the background, and then your character's model is standing there, right?
Yeah, Yeah, my character's model isn't standing there.
I had the same problem, actually.
Wait. It says you pick Lady Tender.
Yeah.
Okay, it so shows start the skills. So you haven't picked her yet, then, if you chose your skills.
Nope. Hold up.
Dude, just follow my thing, my direction. Okay. So at the very top, where you say, top middle, it says play, pets, craft, watch, right?
Yes.
Okay, click play. It goes back to the main screen, right?
Yes.
Okay, click play Strife.
Okay.
It goes back to where you were?
It has pets on the left, a whole bunch of them.
Okay.
Like portraits of them?
Now, is Mystic available there?
There. I'm sorry, the fucking overlay on the goddamn curse thing was covering it up.
Fuck, yeah, that's annoying. Okay, yeah, you can drag that all around or get rid of it or whatever.
Oh, she has other skins?
Yeah, and right now it's Black Friday. But right, I have 100
gems. Oh my god, look at her fucking mushroom-ass fucking shit.
Right, I have 100 gems from the free thing, and I might actually buy the black color dye for 50 gems. I have 100 for free. And it only costs 50 gems on the with the Black Friday thing. I can get the skin as well, but I'd use 80 of my gem. And I don't really like that skin.
You can do account boost too.
Yeah, it makes you level up a little faster, which no. But the thing is, I don't know what the point of that is anymore now that the pets don't level up. I don't know what you really just get the bonuses, I guess. I don't know.
Okay, yeah, I got that fucking shit under control now. Sorry about that. Jesus.
Okay. That's fine. No, it is a little confusing. And now on the left side, if you want to reselect your hero or your pet, just click that big red repick button and do it from there.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, I remember the power word shield she has, the turret. That's awesome. Chain heal and pull them to you like a fucking boss, which I always miss.
Now, if you want to go ahead of time and create your build, so that way in game you don't have to be searching for items, the build thing is fully functional now.
Okay, where's that?
So we're on the same screen. We see where it says hero builds on the left.
Yeah.
Click on the little pencil thing where it says edit build.
Yeah.
Okay, click that. Put new build. Name it whatever the fuck.
Okay.
I'll tell you kind of the base, what you would go, a kind of common build if you want.
Okay.
So on the build order, on the ability order, QWE ult, I'll tell you what you should kind of basically go. And all you do is click on the icons and all I can go slot is boom, 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 okay?
Okay, yeah, QWE.
Yeah, so and you can change this, of course, based on the game and what skills you like. This is just to get you started. So starting from the beginning, just click on the one that I say.
All right.
Q.
Yeah.
W. W. Yeah.
Okay.
E. W. R.
Okay.
W. Okay. Max E, okay. So click E as much as you can. Okay. R.
Okay.
Max Q and then R. So basically, right, you're getting your pull for the pull for the quick early game disable / ass saver, and then you're going all heal and support, all heal and support, all heal and support, all heal support, and then when the time is right, then you max your Q, because really all that's going to do is increase the stun, which you just needed one rank for the oh shit moments really.
Right.
Okay. So So number one item would be to get probably the mana ring for the team. It's called Archmage's Ring.
Okay.
Ryan, you played Tinder a little bit, so if you disagree with anything, let me know. Mana ring.
Archmage ring?
Yep.
Yes.
Okay, I got that in the starting item slot.
Oh, wait, hold on.
God help me, Lord.
Might be a good idea. Crystal and
for, but he's going pure support. I think.
Well, the thing about power though is also
right, but he's gonna have some power in the arc, in the arc majoring. Just okay. A little bit, but that manner reason. So you can do once you learn the game and understand items and stuff, you can fuck off with my stuff. This is just you haven't played in a while.
Yeah, I'm
so arc majoring. Yeah. Right. So just all you do is type in arc, it'll pop up. Or you just,
yeah, I got
just click it.
It
or drag it. Okay.
Yeah, arc there's majoring, a lot of parts to it. Wait, no, it doesn't. I'm stupid. Yeah.
Well, and the thing is later on you can craft an arc majoring using the elixir, and then you can customize what goes into it. Like, and for example, plus mana in that is fucking stupid.
Oh, right.
Because it's an opening item, you always want mana regen. So you can make it 2 mana regens and a power shard for extra healing and damage. And then your arc majoring would have much better stats then. Yeah, but for now, you don't have crafted items. Who gives a fuck? So arc majoring, next you can get like your boots. I would go boots next. And your boots are whatever the fuck you want. I mean,
any kind?
Whatever boots you'd like. So hold on. So on the items to the left, click the X on the input area to get rid of arc or whatever.
Oh, yeah, yeah. In. Yeah, I'm looking on all the boots.
Yeah, click on the boots. So power boots, just movement speed, straight up power. Unexciting, but powerful. Hello. Fervor boots are for carries. Inertia boots, no. Really, the choices are rune boots are good.
Inertia boots removes all sun slows and shit.
Yeah,
and
reduction. But it's more of a tanky item with a plus health. All your benefit is from the off chance you get hit by a CC. Other than that, you have no benefit from it.
Okay.
And they're not bad, but I think like rune boots are good. They give you move speed. They give you constant 15% cooldown reduction, and then you can press D, as in dick, to activate your boots and give yourself that ability, and you get 20% of your health and mana back over 3 seconds. So it's kind of a good sustain.
Yeah, using items. That's where I fucking blow dick too. God.
Well, but every boot in the game except for one can be used. So pressing D to use boots, at least I understand activatable items. There's a lot of them, and you can get a little over top. Ryan says he doesn't do great with them sometimes. I forget you have them or whatever. Right. Yeah. But
okay, I got those then.
Rune boots are good, and then of course warp boots are good, but maybe for a little bit more advanced, you can teleport to an ally, so you can like be pushing one lane and teleport into a fight. Rocket boots are even good on her for escaping or jumping forward and landing your vine, but again, those are a little more advanced. So I think rune boots are pretty good and safe.
Okay.
Next, I would go with a wind rush. And again,
what's that
later under? You can just type in wind. Uncheck boots. Okay, Windrush. Again, another activatable item, but supports have a lot of activatables. Dude, fucking, we're trying to chase down somebody for that final kill. Windrush. We're trying to get the fuck out of there because we're about to die. Windrush. We need to get somewhere quick across the map. Windrush. It's just a fucking great item, dude.
What item is that? What button is that bound to automatically?
All those numbers. So your abilities will be QWER, like every MOBA ever. And then all your activatables will go into 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 slots automatically.
Okay.
It'll be right above your QWER. And then in this game, you can actually move those around. So if you like Windrush on 1, but you build Mana Ring first and it's already on 1, you can actually swap them in your inventory in the bottom left, and you can move your Windrush to 1 and have it on 1 if that's what you choose.
Okay.
Which I do that a lot. I do a lot of changing items around. All right. So those are the main. I would say that's core. I would say that those are. You're starting out. That's your main three, in my opinion.
Mm-hmm.
Then you can go into like more expensive items. Hexbane is good. Basically another activatable, but it's basically hexes the enemy so they can't use abilities or attack. Rune Scepter is good. Gives power and cooldown. Cooldown reduction. Ryan, what else do you normally go on this motherfucker? I mean, it's not normally the mana ring and the the wind rush are like to me the main supporty items.
I think it's
activatable. Oh yeah, the a lot of activatables. Rune Scepter is a good solid item.